Rolling.
We're here at Art Alley in South Lansing with Lily, a fascinating artist who's combined Chinese art with modern art. Lily, tell us a little bit about when you started as an artist.
I started when I was a kindergartner and just joined the competition and won the first prize. So I started feel like maybe I have talent in art. My parents started encouraging me to learn art from a different studio. That later on in high school, I decided to go to art college, so I'm more serious taking an oil painting class and a Chinese art lesson. Now, by the time I go to college, I will concentrate on Chinese painting for quite a while. And later on, I come to the United States. It's a long story because I went to Ohio State University first, then coming to Central Michigan University, learning the computer graphic art, and later on in modern painting. So this series is just a combination of my history of Chinese painting and the modern art. A combination of both.
Now tell us about this piece behind us here. This is a featured piece, you said.
Yes, this piece called Don't Wait for Tomorrow. It's a, the poem outside, the Chinese poem is a quite common Chinese poem about you work hard today, don't wait tomorrow, because tomorrow, after tomorrow, and then pretty soon you're going to be old, and you never know how many tomorrow you're going to have. So, combination of a modern art, I used all the different new figure, all the women, you can see like in between, try to present them like you have to work hard, you have to strive hard, you have to kind of try your best for every day in your life.
Wow, that's beautiful. And the colors, you use such rich colors
yes.
in all of what you've done
yes.
here. Let's move over to this series here. You've got a series of four beautiful nude sketches, sort of, with
yes.
Chinese symbols in the background.
Yes.
Tell us about those.
Oh, those are the nude sketches I do in the art class. And I really like because I feel like my strength is my line art is pretty good because I'm learning Chinese painting for many years and Chinese painting is a brush.
Mm-hmm.
So you kind of very firm with your drawing. So I want to put those drawing in the foreground and combine with the background with all the Chinese writing, all the kind of Chinese poem.
Mm-hmm.
And also with some kind of seal, I try to use gold color, red color to present some ancient seal in the background to create like a today's color modern day, but we also need to reflect our history on the Asian day because without the always the history of all the men and women struggling for us to build the history, culture of us today, no, we will not have today's art. So we're kind of doing this combination and also present cross cultural Chinese culture and this European American culture kind of converged together.
And if we could read Chinese, would we be able to read poems in the background there?
Yes, that's why I translate all the poems.
They're all right there on the wall.
So you're showing the whole idea about what the poem and what the... You want to try to read the one poem for people?
Oh, sure. Here's a brief one. This last one is the most
important.
Let's read that. It says, spring water, spring pond, full of spring wind and nourished spring grass. Spring people drink spring wine, spring birds play songs of spring. Love it. Let's move on down the wall here to some more really dramatic colors. I like the yellows and the reds and the greens and we just read about spring here, but this looks like spring colors here.
Yes.
What can you tell me about this four or five panel piece here? Is this a modern art technique where you use different panels?
This is more like a Chinese style. You use different panels. Chinese painting, they like to use four or five different panels to present one piece painting. So I try to use the panel to present like this is the modern Eiffel Tower with the background with all these abstract color, very modern color. But then you have all the Chinese art
like the floral blossoms.
The cherry blossom all over the place. So create a the combination of cross-cultural film. Here's ancient Chinese art, here's modern scenery, and so kind of just a playful color, a screen color.
And here in the foreground is a man and a woman. Is
yes.
that someone significant?
Yes, because my many years ago, I